Hey folks, Mike McAllister here from Ollie, and today I want to walk through the Ollie Setup Wizard and show you exactly how easy it is to configure a new WordPress website with the Ollie block theme. Now, if you've ever created a new WordPress website, you know that there's a whole laundry list of tasks that you need to do before you can actually get to designing and building your website. You have to change specific settings, get specific plugins installed, create new pages, and a whole bunch of other stuff. And on top of that, you have to jump around the WordPress interface because all of these tasks are in different places. But what if we could streamline these tasks and just handle them all in one place at one time? And now I'm happy to say that with the Ollie block theme, now we can do just that. Let's take a look at how easy it is to go from a default WordPress install to a fully set up and ready to customize website. Okay, so here we are in a brand new fresh WordPress install with the default theme. And let's see how quickly we can take this from a blank canvas to a more impressive website with Ollie and the Setup Wizard. So I'm gonna hop over to the WordPress admin and go to the themes page, and I'm gonna activate the Ollie theme. You can find out more about Ollie and download it at olliewp.com. Let's go ahead and click activate. You can see here we're met with a pop-up, and it basically is introducing Ollie, saying, "Welcome to Ollie," let's head over to the Ollie dashboard where we can see more about the theme and start the setup wizard. So we can go ahead and do that. And you can see here we're popped into an interface that looks very similar to the site editor. And that's the whole idea, to create a seamless experience here. Now, I've created a whole video on the Ollie dashboard where we go through the different pages. So go ahead and check that out. I'll link that. But we're going to focus on the setup wizard here. So you can see we have right away, we have a button that says go to the setup wizard. I can also click over here in the sidebar to get there. But let's go ahead and click go to the setup wizard. And let's get started. You can see here there's a way of navigating on the left here. But we're going to mostly do it through the interface here on the right. So let's get started. Okay, so just a TLDR. This is a way of hopping through different settings that we have to set up on every WordPress website, and just brings all of those things into one streamlined interface. So let's go ahead and get started. So site title and tagline is something we always have to set up, so feel free to change this, or it pulls the current setting, so you can leave it as is if you want. And next is setting up our permalinks. How do we want our links to look on the front end? Do we want to use the default, you know, P equals 1, 2, 3, kind of that kind of number based system? Or do we want the more SEO friendly and easier to read post names? So we'll go with post name here, and I'm going to click save and continue. Now we can set up our brand, our style. Let's pick some colors that match our company and our brand. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose a color palette. Ollie ships with several different color palettes, and basically this just gives your site kind of an overall design aesthetic. And so I'm gonna choose pink, and that's gonna load, as you can see, a color palette that has a pink accent color, but then it also has some really kind of nice subtle pink undertones, and that is the same for all of them. So you get kind of a nice, beautiful design out of the box. So I'm going to choose pink. And then in this option here, we can choose our specific brand color. So if we have a specific hue or hex color that we want to choose, we can. I'm just going to choose one and say that's my brand color. And now that will be used throughout all of the patterns, all of the buttons and everything. That color will propagate, and we'll be able to use that throughout our design. Our logo, let's go ahead and select the logo. The Ollie header by default is dark. You can change any color you want, but it's dark by default, and I'm gonna choose a light logo to go with that. The site icon, so the site icon is also called a favicon, is the very tiny icon that shows up in your browser tab. So it's the name, it's the little icon next to the name of your site. You can choose an image for that if you want to create a tiny image and get in some image editing software and do that. You can create your own image. But we've also added an option for you to simply choose an emoji. So you can choose any of the emojis available on your system. You know, they don't have to be silly. There's all kinds of emojis that can represent your site. You know, you have a cool radioactive sign, or who knows, whatever you want, a little sundial there. I'm just going to choose this kind of cool green one. And as you can see here, it shows us a preview of what that's going to look like in the browser tab. So that looks good to me. Let's go ahead and save and continue. All right, create pages. So one of the most powerful things about block themes and Ollie is the pattern designs that come with a theme. The patterns help us create designs quickly. They're page sections and full page designs. And when you put them together, you can get a nice, beautiful page. So what we can do with the site wizard then is to create those pages for you automatically. You don't have to go and create the page and apply the pattern and apply the template. We'll just do all that for you here. So by default, we create the home page and the blog, but let's go ahead and create a few more pages to work with here. So I'm gonna go ahead and click a few of those. Okay, now let's hit create pages and continue. And what happened there on the underside, we just handled all of that. We created the page, we applied the pattern, we applied the template, and those pages are now available in our page list and they're available to use. So we can use those in this next setting, which lets us set up the homepage and blog. What do we want on our homepage? What do we want on our blog page? So by default, WordPress uses your latest posts. So you can see here, that's what's happening. This is a live preview, so we can see exactly what's going on, what we're gonna get. We can choose to keep our latest posts if we want, but let's go ahead and set up a custom page so we can use one of those cool pages that we just created. So I'm gonna click custom page, and then I'm gonna choose home. And as I scroll through, you can see I get a live preview. The color palette that we chose is coming through. Everything's looking good. This is the page I wanna go with. And so that looks good. So if I click over to blog then, you can see similarly, this is the blog that I created, and this is the one we'll go with. This looks good. So we were able to visually see exactly what we were creating. We didn't have to guess. We didn't have to go create those pages ourselves. We just moved right by that. So now let's click save and finish. We get a pop of confetti, and just like that, we're already done with the main setup of our site. I've given you a few options here. We can go view our site. Let's do that. An option to jump right into the site editor so we can start editing this right away and customize it further. A link to the Ollie docs, and a way of creating and activating a child theme. And the child theme is helpful if you want to customize the underlying code further while still maintaining the bulk of the Ollie parent theme. So let's go ahead and check out our site. Now you can see, just like that, this is the page that we set up in the site wizard. We don't have that blank canvas anymore. We got a full website, cool homepage, the color palette's coming through, everything looks good, and this is ready to go. We can now continue to customize this further. We can go into the site editor and change the navigations and use the site logo, which will automatically pull in the logo that we had set up. And that's basically it. Just like that, we're able to cut out all those steps. 15, 20 minutes of jumping around the WordPress admin is like gone. We don't have to do that anymore. So yeah, I hope this was super helpful. Let me know what you think. What do you think of this feature? What else would you like to see in the site wizard? What else are you doing every time that you'd rather not be doing anymore? Maybe we can come up with a solution for that. So let me know what you think. Stay tuned to the next video in this series of videos. We're going to keep walking through and showing off all kinds of tips and tricks for WordPress and Ollie and the site editor and the site wizard and all of that stuff. And that's all I have. Thanks for hanging out. We'll see you next time.